Keyboards, while they are not used by every group or band, are some of the most important and distinct sounds in music, from the classical composers to John Lord from Deep Purple. And Jordan Rudess of Dream Theater. But did you know, keyboard instruments weren't always like this. This is a Hammond C3 organ. Now, while it has a very interesting and unique sound, it was originally made to replace the oldest keyboard instrument of all time, the pipe organ. As was already stated, the oldest keyboard instrument is the pipe organ. While it didn't originally use the keyboard layout that is in use today, it still used buttons and levers which formed a keyboard. It is also believed that the organ was used during gladiator matches. But the Hammond organ, it doesn't really sound much like an organ, does it? And that's when Jimmy Smith, a famous jazz musician, realized how much potential the instrument had. The Hammond's imperfections made it the perfect instrument for jazz and soul. After Jimmy Smith found the instrument, so did Booker T. Jones. Booker T. Jones was famous for this song, Green Onions. But one musician found it impossible to completely leave his classical music behind and decided to bring the Hammond organ into rock music. His name is John Lord. John Lord played keyboards for the group Deep Purple, who are famous for this song, Smoke on the Water. Now John Lord, looking for a more aggressive sound, and also claiming that his organ wasn't fully supporting their guitarist, eventually ended up running his organ through a Marshall guitar stand.
John needed to get really the organ sound very similar to a guitar. So instead of putting the organ through Leslie's originally, when they got together, he put it through a Marshall stack. So you got this abrupt, very harsh sound, which complements the guitar perfectly.
Space trucking is an entire section of the organ doing the,
John. It's actually an electric piano. Organ together.
The major difference of the sound of the band was the fact that there was this glorious Hammond organ. Sometimes taking the lead part in certain tracks which people consider to be guitar tracks.
It's only when you get to the verse that the guitar comes in, and that's all he's doing.
But the piano, arguably the most popular keyboard instrument of all time, was not the first of its kind. The harpsichord, which the piano later evolved from, looks similar to the piano but makes a completely different, distinct sound, as you can hear. With a piano, the strings are hit with hammers, and with a harpsichord, the strings are plucked. The harpsichord is believed to have been invented sometime during the Middle Ages. But after its creation, the piano soon gained popularity because it allowed you to play loudly and softly. The piano is capable of playing at different volumes depending on how hard you press the keys. The harpsichord, however, does not change volume no matter how hard you strike the key. But what about recent keyboard evolution? How is the keyboard used today? This is a Novation Mini Nova. Now, this is a special type of keyboard called a synthesizer. And the synthesizer generates its own sound by using circuits and electronics and other computer type software. Apart from being able to do incredible electronic sounds, it can also emulate other instruments, such as a Hammond organ. Synthesizers were made popular in the 60s with rock and psychedelic music. It also had a role in funk music. Funk music then led to hip-hop and rap, and then all forms of dance music, and well, there's really too many styles of music that synthesizers are in to list. Even in heavy metal, Jordan Rudess from Dream Theater uses the synthesizer to create new sounds and to emulate other classic instruments.
Down here, the Supernova that I really love. It's the one Novation keyboard I have in the room with me now, and it came out some years ago, but it had a very, very fat sound. I actually took the Radius with me on the road with Dream Theater a couple of years ago. Used two of them on tour, actually. Below it, my Nord keyboard, the Nord Wave. Also, very nice keyboard.
But however keyboards are being used, they will always have an important role in the music industry.